playing at the Jax's Insta-Locked. All here right. we go.
Now, Jax Jungle. We have a couple of aficionados, in fact, in our next
Red's
match.
Turning up as well, but is Keen going to survive? The answer's no. First Blood goes over to Rascal as the Realm Warp is going to deliver the Afrika Freaks to the top side, but this isn't where they want to be. Flash already down from UCal, and everyone dives on top. The Leap Strike, the Blade Surge, and Kingzone get two. Down top side as the Realm Warp is being delivered to Neon. He's going to get into the brush. The flash from UCal, though, is going to be the follow-up as Neon taken down where he stands. And Kingzone has hit level 9 here. It's not quite the level 6. That would have been the earlier option as Def. True Shot Barrage lands onto center. Neon's going to turn up. Teleport in from UCal. Remember, doesn't have his flash as Neon might be in trouble now as well. Rascal's going to turn up. Vanguard's Edge is out. A lot of damage being done as Tucson is going to be able to save Rascal in the nick of time. He's got the Grey Health that he can eat and isn't going to have to as the barrel comes down. Neon does have a shield for himself. Don't know whether it's going to be enough though as Aiming's trying to use that final hour. Gets in there and locks down the Karma, and it looks like they'll transition into a Drake as well.
Well, that was a party down the bot lane. The only person who could not join was Cuz, who gets it up.
Times. Rascal moving on down to the river here as Keen and Dread might be routed. Flawless Duet does come in there as Keen boops them all away. The barrel's going to help out there as well as the Afrika Freaks are trying to work things out. Not able to though as Rascal grabs that first kill. Blade Surge comes in again onto Dread, who's going to go down to Neon. And Kingzone have fought back here and now... You know, Senen didn't get that memo though. He was so far up the lane and just engaged on so easily by Rascal and the rest of Kingzone. Four members down underneath this turret. UCal, what are you doing here, buddy? That is not where you want to be. Double teleports come in, though, and they do answer back. As now Cuz in potential trouble. Neon trying to keep Deft alive. He's able to do it for a while, but not long enough. It is now Keen. May have gone too far, but Cuz as well might be falling into that trap and does go down. Tucson a little bit late.
Wait, my age a little bit. Because that was
people nowadays are like, oh,
I think
Switch,
they played that one in the gold rush. Now Dread in trouble once again, but the health bars are back up to above half of the Afrika Freaks. Another Flawless Duet comes out. Senen has been engaged on Vanguard's Edge. It's huge damage onto the front line, but UCal able to get himself out of there with the flash. The Braum is dead, and now Keen running for the hills. He's got a full health bar.
King Zone will be able to lock this one down.
Members has to flash immediately now as Keen might be out of position, is going to be punished into the GA, and Afrika have overstepped. The first mistake comes down from our blue side squad, and now Kingzone should.
Afrika's Elder Drake has spawned. It's 36 minutes, the Baron goes down.
Kingzone are going to be able to lock that one up, and Afrika don't quite know what to do. Only four members on the map right now, as the True Shot Barrage will spot that Afrika are not doing. The Big Bad Dragon.
I don't know if they've reset or if they're doing some guerrilla warfare around their blue buff.
Oh, this is so cute. It looked like they weren't there, but they've started it up, and now the Elder Drake will be the trade for the Baron buff. So cute out of the Afrika Freaks.
Kingzone understood they didn't have the ability to check either because the vision was all gone, and they hope
just trade it up. Straight up.
Yeah. And the game is going to extend, right? And then Afrika can utilize their scaling advantages. Now Rascal trying to fight UCal, and he's going to do it easily. Took a lot of damage. Didn't even need the teleport in from Neon, and this might be the mistake that costs it.
Freaks right now, Flawless Duet doesn't get a stun. Senen below half health. Now looking to try and go forward. Def in trouble, but Devourer is there. As in goes Cuz.
Looks for the stuns, gets the counter-strike. Lands it onto Aiming, but he's so incredibly strong. Cuz tries to flash, but he's going to die. Afrika, they've got their rise back, and now they've got the team fight. Three already dead, and Neon and Tucson, they can't do anything against this squad. Aiming at full health, having a field day in this fight.
Able to reset aggro a couple of times. Here's the Realm Warp.
Realm Warp comes in. Neon below half health. The flash from Tucson, but he's going the wrong direction. Now trying to fight against Dread, and Dread doesn't exactly have a lot of buttons. He gets eaten, but now Keen will be able to close on
the catfish.
And it looks like Afrika have done it against Kingzone, who managed to get that Baron. They pick up the Elder Drake, though, and they've got a huge Vayne. Going to be able to take down these Nexus turrets, and what an exciting game one to begin this best of five.
Aiming was able to live through that, the double lifesteal to frontline flash out and return to the fight. And even though Afrika made their share of mistakes, they're going to win game one.
They are. Nexus is going to go down. They waited long enough. The Vayne got big enough, and Afrika will block.
Final results, straight up Pyke, a Tucson favorite. He loves Predator Pyke on the red side, but this is not the Tahm Kench free lane into Dread has up. He's very unlikely to be bot side.
Bone Skewer is going to come in here as Senen. Remember, doesn't have flash. The ignite is ticking once again, and Pyke going to be able to lock down that kill super easily.
Now aiming one versus three. Around the mid-game. And Afrika, against the run of play, are going to be able to take the first trade.
I do feel like Yasuo should be able to
have soul vision of this area. In they go. Great barrel there from Kuz. His Gragas is always so good, and it continues to be so. As the depth from below is going to that kill on the top side of the map. We weren't able to grab it. Grab for the static shiv variety as Realm Warp is going to get channeled there. Flashes, but Abscond is there. That's a bit of a misplay from Yukal, but he didn't have too many other options. Throws his flash away.
They push in, they have priority there. They chase away the Karma, and they get the Mountain Drake. And when we want to see a Draven with some shield.
On in, throws down the barrel, locks it in. On to aiming. Is he going to get taken down, though? Yes! Tucson locks down the kill. Rascal diving on forward. Dredd's going to get taken out. It's a double kill. Money everywhere for Kingzone. The triple death from below as Death dives onto Yukal. And Kingzone are now trying to chase down the scraps.
Uh-oh.
Realm Warp coming on in. It was stolen and Yukal's life is going to suffer the same fate. But no, the turret is going to be enough to deter.
Two with a level playing field.
Yep, and those adoration stacks as well are now going to suffer. All right.
How about how strong Kingzone is right now? They're 10,000 gold.
Maybe he's going to get slowed there. That actually could be a big deal. The Mantra Q going to go completely wide as Rascal's going to steal away a Whirling Death. Throws it out immediately. Three man! Barrel comes down. The last breath is going to be in as Kane is stabbed to death on the backline. Meanwhile, it's Deft cleaning up the frontline. Dredd running away. It's a catastrophe for the Afrika Freaks, and Kingzone have come alive.
I think that should be one done. You'd think Dredd is considering his options, hoping to join the other team.
There's
bad
the flash
news.
Bone skewer. He does go golden,
whoa,
so denies the
vote.
Extra money. But who cares? It's the ace. Tucson locks it down. And we're moving towards potentially what looks like a perfect game when it comes to the kills. The inhibitor turret goes down, and I believe the Nexus will be shortly following.
11-0. Not a football scoreline, and yet that is a stat line here in terms of kills. Kingzone closed it, didn't even break into a sweat, and after the long pause, Kingzone come out, heads held high.
Yeah, big flash in onto aiming there as well. Just for good measure, Rascal's going to clean up. The Nexus goes down before he can, and Kingzone answer back. It's a tied series in this best of five, and it's Kingzone right.
Support one time.
Well, Shen's been locked in, so
I'm
honestly,
not sure.
We don't know yet. I hope that it's Shen top. That would be cool. Huh. On Kingzone's side, Voidseek a fair bit of damage there onto aiming, as you can see. As Senen, he threads the needle, and the wall comes down as well, but jumps off it immediately. The taunt is going to turn around as Kuz moves on in. Neon gets it. That is going to be the WR punch to the face, and First Blood goes.
I'm going to take this to remember Shen has ult.
Yep, that's a huge flash in, though. The knockoff, the layering of CC is fantastic as Dredd goes gold, and Senen finds himself with Deft in front of him, and the Gragas is already dead. Senen just trying to run out of here. Couple more autos as Def does throw down the ult and Keen misses the shock blast. Senen's going to probably die as an afterthought as the Karma picks up that kill, and now Yukal trying to get something back as Rascal gets himself the ultimate and Def another sidestep. Neon over the wall tidies this one up as True Shot Barrage is going to go wide. We do have the passive coming down as Yukal immediately cleanses. Seismic Shove is going to get rid of not the real LeBlanc. And they haven't even found a kill yet. It's Tucson with another sidestep. Damn, Kingzone. Their button pressing ability today is looking pretty damn good.
Here's the Weaver's Wall. They want to clean up some kills. Interrupted.
Oh, no. There we go. Void Rush comes down, but he does have the seismic shove. And now Kuz might just eat these threaded volleys. Oh. Another tunnel, not enough. And Yukal is going to.
As Rascal doesn't land that Q, but Kuz moves on over. Will be able to get the CC down as the Void Rush
gets rid of the turret aggro. And Kuz is easily able to lock down the kill under the J side. If they can even get that.
They need to complete the top lane turret.
Famously performed.
Yeah.
It's top bot lane.
Yep, Rascal in trouble. He's going to get booped back as another seismic shove landing and a very late flash. You got to flash before you get booped. And I think
he's early power spike pick comp. Hasn't really been able to do that for a while. Afrika are making about their game. Neon.
What the heck? He just
dead.
Dived into his death.
Yep.
That's called a faceplant, ladies and gentlemen, and now the turret might suffer a similar.
Allow Kuz to get forward. Speaking of forward, Deft is going to dive onto Keen, who has to flash to get out of the way.
I don't think he's out of harm's way yet, though, as Deft picks up that kill comfortably onto the Jace. Exactly what Kingzone were looking for.
And that was the big turning point in game number two. Keen being caught. This one won't lead to a Baron, but Infernal is high value.
Neon's
got the Banshee Veil this time, so he can be a little bit more wanted with his aggression.
Aiming. That's a lot of burst damage. The flash forward from Neon. He's still looking for aiming. It's Cuz. Locks it down with the ultimate. Two kills so quickly in this fight is now Dread in so much trouble. The flash forward, the auto attack, and Cuz locks that one up as Deft. He deals with the Drake as an afterthought as now Yukal is bringing Kingzone towards the Baron. He has position, he has the vision, and now he has the Baron.
Baron was confirmed for the side.
Many people have much of a health bar. Is now Dread looking for the Predator. Gets forward but doesn't land the body slam. Is now aiming. He's very low. Another Void Seeker comes in as a stopwatch. He's going to buy some time. Deft over the top. But a huge knock up from Senen. But I think they're too far behind. Cuz survived for so damn long as Neon gets into the backline and steals away a triple kill.
Neon giveth, Neon taketh away, he wants another.
Yep, he's just walking after Yukal. There's a seismic shove. All too easy as Rascal grabs the kill.
There was a whole lot of people riding down the Karma train. The Karma Chameleon is going to pick up the victory here as Kingzone going 2-1 up after that game one loss.
No one was predicting this. I was talking to all the Korean casters beforehand and they were thinking, oh, Afrika Freak's probably going to take it. Kingzone after that 2-week break. Looking a whole lot better, not going to win. Poked out by the Void Seeker, and Afrika just looks like they're getting corralled. There's no Alistar on this composition, but it looks like they're all in the paddock.
They've got no home.
Yeah, Kingzone dictating exactly where Afrika are allowed to be and just poking them out here as well, playing with their food. As in goes Tucson. He's had enough of this playtime. It is a big cast, but they just don't have enough money. Deft decides that it's over. A double kill for the Rek'Sai. An explosion of damage. It's a full house. Kaisers full
are styling on their graves as they will win game number 3.
And they'll move to match point as well as Rascal. He had a couple of abilities to go golden there. The golden Karma top is going to win finally.
Korean teams have moved away from us, prepping with the Korean casters before the LCK final. They were adamant that Kennen was gone, at least for that.
Now Cuz is making his way down. He's been so active, aiming, flashing so early, knowing that Cuz was probably on the way in, and even manages to get the longest flash ever, and aiming's going to burn down to the red buff. It should be a double kill here, but Senen gets the Titan's Wrath back. Dread dives on in, but that's called inting, my friends. Double kill for Cuz. They're already fantastic early game with this. This is called a sandwich, ladies and gentlemen. Dread dives on over the top, but Neon's already killed the Kaisa as an afterthought. The chain's going to go wide, but the wind... Their horror of a final part of summer. Better late than never, Papa.
I'll do the research. I apologize, I didn't do the
We're going for a pick here.
Yeah, dives in onto Senen. He's going to die before being able to use the aftershock, but no, goes golden, keeps himself alive for a little bit longer, eventually dies as the Silas once again. Dives into the middle of the enemy team, and he's very dead. Keen gets a huge slicing maelstrom as aiming. He dived in, but he just couldn't close the gap, and Kingzone have killed everyone apart from aiming, and Rascal wants to rectify that situation as well. They get the flash, Tucson doesn't die.
Incredibly low, and Kuz gonna solo out this Cloud Drake, get himself over this wall, and continue amassing gigantic amounts.
Decided Blade of the Ruined King was necessary this game, just to play more aggressively. Yep, and he's going to. Slicing Maelstrom does nothing. That probably could have been a 1v1 as Neon is going to finish it off in the end, but that got a
Yeah, we can see exactly where he is. He's got no information. Wait, we can't kill him.
You caught Cuz.
Wait, they almost did end damage. Did they? Did they? Okay. Claws his way out as Dread. Is he going to throw his life away once again? Yes, he is. Dives right in on top. Cuz taking a lot of damage. Dread does die as Slicing Maelstrom's trying to take down Tucson, but he goes golden. The culling onto Keen as Neon gets rid of Nautilus as aiming dives in to the back line. It will be a suicide mission, though, as Rascal looking to jump on top of Yukal. He does so, and Rascal just celebrates by pressing R, running to the mid lane after the Kingzone ace.
Sometimes you gotta
twist. He was one of the people to go down and still has a gold bounty on him.
Further to heal off of the Slicing Maelstrom, I guess.
As Yukal knocking it, he missed one. Oh my goodness, as Rascal, Worldender is up, but there's no Morella Nomicon, remember, that's a good knockup. As aiming, wants to get in there, but Rascal's gonna take the 2v1, not mind about it, and deliver himself to the turret instead. Coming out of death there as well, of course, does scale with AP, and especially when it's picked up from Dread, as that's a decent ultimate coming out from Tucson, as Cuz once again doing the ambition trick and easily takes down the Nautilus before he can even think of trying to re-engage. And a turret gonna go down. Good God, that burst damage.
Freaky just straight up can't walk through, so As long as Cuz stays on the map, there's not a lot that they can do. As once again, another Cataclysm flies in. The depth charge is on top of him, but no one can follow up, and Senen's just going to die even through the aftershock.
How's it healing?
Yeah, good God. Aiming dives on forward. Oh my God, Depth is still alive! As Keen can't do enough. That's what happens when your wallets are this damn heavy. And Yukal can't do anything against Rascal, who will just smash him in the face with his gigantic sword. And I think, ladies and gentlemen, that was all she wrote. The inhibitor turret is going to go down, and this should be just the game for Kingzone.
Kingzone look in renewed form, almost the same as the last time we could say that back at Rift Rivals 2019. Kingzone want to go to Worlds, and Afrika certainly won't be the team that will stop them.
Yep, 24 minutes into this game, Senen is an afterthought as he pops underneath the Nexus turret. Second one going to go down here as Dread has been not having the best game of his life, and they're not even going to look at him. He tries to flash onto Death, but he's going to die. Cuz grabs that kill, and now Kingzone just want to mop this one up before the Nexus goes down, but they can't do that. Too much damage.